Hey, so we are back on the couch, another week, another movie. The week has dawned. That's been a while. Hence that one. Yeah, first up with this one is Layer Cake. Which was a suggestion, right?
Mm-hmm. There were several people who pulled, I don't know, not as many as Dead Man's Shoes. I think Dead Man's Shoes got about 30.
Jeez.
Layer Cake's gotten maybe a dozen or so. I'm not really sure, but I've seen it. It was ages ago. Mm. I don't remember what it's about. I know it's gangster world, but all I remember is there's a speech in it that, like, it's on YouTube all the time, and that Daniel Craig's in it. That's it.
Okay.
As for what the story is and all that, I've just completely blocked out of my head. It's kind of like Rock and Roll. I just forgot it.
Yeah, well, I haven't seen this one, so looking forward to it. I don't know anything about it at all, actually, now that I think
about it.
We're
pretty close to zero on this, but I think it's a little bit more on the Snatch side of things than on the Dead Man's Shoes side of things, as far as, like, you know, Dead Man's Shoes is just, like, raw doc style, like, no bullshit, no fancy cuts, no cranes, no steady cam. Like, I'm not going to say it was, like, low production value. It was, like, the look he was going for was just simple. We're not messing about here. Mm-hmm. And I feel like Layer Cake's a little more swoopy.
Trainspotting and then T2.
Yeah, I mean, those are all, like, stylish.
They're very stylish, but the second one, More Money, More Whatever Else, got even more stylish. It definitely played for that movie. First, she was. It made sense, though. It worked for that story really well.
Yeah, Shane Meadows did. For Dead Man's Shoes, that worked really effectively for that, because that movie felt so, like, a raw nerve, which is what it was. I would actually put that up against any of the other ones that we've seen, and, you know, even Snatch, and say, you know, for pure emotional, just, like, punch, mm-hmm. this movie really hits hard. Afterwards, I was like, wow, that movie was... there's nothing to it, but it's really effective.
So, let's get into this one, and, yeah, enjoy it.
Matthew Vaughn. So, that's the guy who produced... Snatch.
But it wasn't for me. There were villains locked away for 12 years for robbing a bank of 10 grand, doing time with drippy hippies who were doing 12 months for smuggling 2 million quid's worth of puff. Work it out, mate. We're in the wrong game. Drugs changed everything. Always remember that one day all this drug monkey business will be legal. They won't leave it to people like me. Not when they finally figure out how much money there is to be made. Billions. But this is now. So until prohibition ends, make hay while the sun shines. I'm not a gangster. I'm a businessman whose commodity happens to be cocaine. I mean, 10 years ago, a bit of Charlie was... It was demonized by Daily Mail readers getting drunk in naff wine bars. Now they're my biggest clients.
It's pretty nice.
Yeah, it was a neat... Yeah.
It's Tom Hardy.
Oh!
Today, I only deal in kilos. That'll cost you either 28 grand or 15 years in prison, which is more time than a rapist. Always work in a small team. Only deal with people who come recommended. I mean, it's like selling anything. Handmade shoes, blowjobs. As long as you don't take the piss, people will always come back for more. Never be too greedy.
Don't get high off your own supply.
10 cocaine commandments.
Woo, nice pullout for that, too.
Yeah.
Know and respect your enemy. Very, very stupid people who think the law is stupid. And avoid loud, attention-seeking, wannabe gangsters in it for the glory to be a name. They don't mean to f*** up, they just do.
I'm loving these transitions, they're really unique.
Stay away from the end user, I hate guns. And violence. Morty learned to be cautious the hard way, he did 10 years inside. He's my bridge to the criminal world. Pay your supplier prompt. In our case, that's Mr. Jimmy Price. He's the top of the pyramid. Gene here is Jimmy's right-hand man.
Miles Edward O'Brien.
Oh, by the way, Jimmy would like to see you tomorrow for a spot of lunch.
Is there a problem?
So beautiful.
He's beautiful.
We need to get another one. Oh, that guy. He always plays a jerk.
Oh, yeah.
Whereas years ago, scallywags were trying desperately hard to get money out of banks. Now your problem is how to get your ill-gotten gains into the bank. Well, that's a job for Mr. Singh. He does my laundry. And in a week's time, it will be ready for collection in a round million. Quit while you're ahead. Barring any fuck-up, I'm leaving it all behind.
You know what they all say?
Yeah, barring any fuck-ups.
Yeah, better than expected, actually. It's just that things are a little bit slightly turbo this end. Come on, boys, lively, lively.
Life is so fucking good, I can taste it.
Layer Cake. That's dope. They were like, we have a crane. We will be using it.
That might be a copter.
That's a copter. That's a copter for sure.
Mr. Price is in the overview.
Nice little steady cam action.
Yeah. Walking in like they're the coolest guys in the room, because they are.
How you getting on with that packy account?
Roger's doing a very good job.
Good, good. You hungry? The grub here will make your bollocks tingle. That's
it. The grub here will make your bollocks tingle.
What we got to do now is test the old snap, crackle and pop factor on these little babies.
Well, don't ask me. I ain't fucking touching them.
Sit down, mate. Got a little treat for you.
That feels like a little bit of a setup.
What do you want, son?
Excuse me?
In life?
That's a very expansive question.
You know why people like you can't leave this business? Because you make too much money for people like me. I need a favor.
It'll be a pleasure, Mr. Price.
Jimmy, it's not for me, if the truth be told. It's for a good friend of mine, Eddie Temple. Eddie's got a daughter, Charlie, bless her. But she ain't behaving like a lady. She's hooked on the white powder. And this is where you come in. You're going to find her.
You should get a private detective.
Oh, right. Some nosy ex-policeman.
I wouldn't even know where to begin.
Every now and then, we're asked to do something above and beyond the call of duty.
I'll do my best.
I've also got a little business, more in your usual line. Gene will fill you in on the details.
Good boy. I've set up a meet for 5 with the Duke.
Yeah, he's like, I'm screwed. It's not what I do.
What's with him? He's just had one of these. These are super easy, mate. We're gonna make millions!
Why aren't we doing business with the Duke?
Yeah.
Why are we dealing with this Joker?
We're dealing with the Duke because he has 1 million
extra. Can you imagine the calm round that took to be able to do that?
Okay.
1 million. Gene, that is a lot of pills. Oh yeah, driving a bright yellow Range Rover. Very subtle.
Don't go getting Duke up.
Me?
Don't you f***ing talk to me like I'm some kind of mug. Don't you f***ing talk to me like
Duke.
That.
Duke, now you want to know how much these pills are worth?
Yes! F***ing please!
Right, now just because you pay a fiver a pop down the local cattle market, don't, for f***ing sake, start thinking these pills are worth millions. They're not. We've got to find someone to buy these pills. It's hard work.
Oh, you give a f***ing aspirin and headache, pal!
Who has got the readies lying around to pay for 1 million each?
This is f***ing bollocks! That's the son of f***ing up! 5 million easy!
£5 each, yeah?
You are f***ing joking. It doesn't work like that.
Don't keep f***ing saying that to me!
I've got some samples. I'll stay in touch with Gene, okay? Where the f*** did these monkeys get 1 million ease?
Don't worry about that. Can you place them?
Oh, we know someone up north who can buy them.
He's like, this just feels like a bad idea.
Yeah. Oh, hello. Look who it is. Sit down. Do join us.
Can we have a word? Some more champagne.
Yeah, sure.
Especially you. I like it when you're drunk. Oh, we're doing the number on these young American birds.
Yeah. Who am I today?
You, my son, are in fact the Earl of Oxford. So what's this bit of business then, eh?
Well, it's something a bit strange. Can you find somebody for me really quickly?
Well, how quickly?
£20,000 quickly.
Very nice. I suppose this is the boyfriend. It's a bit unusual for you, this, isn't it? What's going on?
Doesn't matter. Can you do it?
Yeah.
Oi! I'm the Duke's nephew!
Sydney! Yeah. Just off. You have a nice night.
I hear you're doing a bit of business with my uncle.
Why don't you tell the whole f***ing room?
She's Tammy!
Yeah, well, stick around and have a drink before you do, yeah?
Yeah. Yep. We'll definitely stay. Yeah, he's smitten.
It's good looking.
Just a thousand light yard stare.
He's just staring at that girl.
Oh, no, for sure. She's beautiful, like, pull out, though.
Cut to her dancing.
Yeah, there you go. No one in the room matters but her.
Lovely, isn't she? Is she a darling?
I wish that happened to me more often.
Someone just give you your
their phone number and says, f*** me or call me or whatever.
You lot would know all about that, wouldn't you?
Do you know something we don't?
Really don't know.
I was over in Amsterdam. The whole place is alight with the rumour about how this hooligan outfit from down your end run by this joker. It's called a Duke.
Get that? Go and find them f***ing pills.
Now he scanned his outfit like a proper, nutty Serbian militia.
No, Mr. Duke. You're the first person ever to be foolish enough to try and steal from me.
Shut up.
But you're not the first adversary to hold against my hand.
Shut up, or I'll be the last.
Ugh, you're just getting yourself in all kinds of fucking mess.
And he got lucky because he just knocked up a massive batch.
That looks very heavy for you.
You were robbing the wrong people.
Why don't you put it down?
Why don't you shut up?
Look at you, little girl playing
little
games.
Girl, why don't you shut up?
You are shaking.
F*** off, why don't you shut up?
Are you just going to show up?
I said, f*** off, yeah.
Put it down.
Yeah.
Because this lot are wanted for f***ing war crimes, mass murder, ethnic cleansing. They're lunatics.
Think about that.
Duke has absolutely sweet f*** all to do with us, understand?
Yep, for sure.
Everyone in Amsterdam believes that he has. Banded your name, suppose? What?
Word on the Straz is they've unleashed their top boy. His name is...
Dragan? Da, domnule. I'm promis că-i tai capul.
Let's talk liberties with them.
But we had absolutely nothing to do with the acquiring of said merchandise.
Okay, we accept that, okay? But with you lot up here, punting this shipment, you tell me, how does it look?
Bad. We're only talking pennies and articles. Stolen goods.
You won't want them then.
Sit down, lad. Let's not be too hasty. Me and him need to have a little think.
Well, don't think too long, because someone's going to make a killing on these pills.
They already have. That's the problem, get out.
I told you he was trouble, didn't I?
He's not answering more.
Try Jimmy at home. Will you f***ing ring him?
What is with this iron? Yep, damn it.
Mm. Oh.
Wow. That was a great shot.
Marry burning a hole in your chest until your heart boils.
Oof. That would be hard to go.
He would have told him anything then, wouldn't he? That's what happens when you do business with loons.
Find out where the Duke's hold up. We're going to need an insurance policy.
What's the f***ing idea?
Yeah, that's a beautiful
question. Phone him alone and leave him messages.
Jimmy, it was an emergency.
He called me Jimmy. And what's the idea of telling Duke those pills ain't worth shit and don't be leaving it for that pair of ponces, Cody and Tiptoes, to be finding that bitch Charlie? Told you to do it.
This guy just can't win. He's just getting screwed over by everybody, and he had it together.
Well, I gotta tell you, the gaff is rotten in there. Kinky still here, is he? He's in here.
Oh dear.
Kinky. You three gearheads are gonna be clucking very soon. In fact, it looks like you're clucking already. You see, we can't do this. One or two ways. We can do it the nice way. Because the other way is that my friend here takes you one by one, puts your head through the f***ing window. Was Charlie here with Kinky?
Yes, he was here for a couple of days. Them two kept arguing. To Sandy, you think it's that easy taking that $5,000 messing them about, but she was still kind on the rocks and smoking the gear.
Where is she now?
Brighton. She kept begging Kinky to go with her. You know, to get away. But I sees this geezer, like, and he's creeping around all in black. It's like something out of a f***ing Kung Fu film, you know?
I know what tangent to him. He's a f***ing nut.
Yes, son, shut the f***. God.
What are you trying to tell me? That somebody's topped Kinky?
Kinky f***ing over, though. He always was a greedy f***er.
Fucking over, man. I saw it with my very own f***er.
You twat! Shut your f***ing mouth!
Money, get the
f***ing
money! Get the
f***ing
money! This is dodgy, mate. That kid's talking about murder.
He's talking shit. Now just get down to Brighton and finish the job.
Oh, nice. The symmetry.
I'm not happy.
No, I'm happy.
Like he's happy.
You sort it out, or I sort you out. Kinky OD, that's all. Cody's gonna find her.
Again, didn't Duke say he wants you to find it?
What do you mean hiding that, eh? Hello, Freddy.
Ugh. Why do I have to watch this man eat?
Stop it! Too much. Ugh. All right, we're almost done.
Gonna spare us a few quick, because for old time's sake, man.
He's loaded.
Well, flush, bruv. That's great.
Could make it 5, could ya? Let's make it 10. A nice, round number.
Ooh. Oh, the great camera work using it as the camera as the guy's head. Brilliant.
He's got some anger issues.
That was brilliant.
Damn.
Ooh. Oh, fuck.
It's getting medieval on this guy.
Let's have a couple teams.
No. Oh, man. Brutal.
Oh, well, homie's dead.
Ooh, look at that. 360?
Yeah, nice one too.
That was impressive.
Oh, and a walkway.
Yep. Oh, nice. He seemed like he had everything together, and then it was like, no, f*** it. I'm pissed.
Yeah, that guy, he went off, man.
How's your day been so far?
Very f***ing funny. Gene, who the f*** is Freddy?
In those days, you were headed up by this guy called Crazy Larry.
Got shot, didn't he? Bit of a lunatic.
Worried about keeping a low profile.
I love you.
Kilburn Jerry. Marty, out of some mad sense of loyalty, actually volunteered to dispose of the body.
Great shot again. Overhead, the rain.
The guy Larry told to help him was Freddie Hurst. Had fallen asleep at some traffic lights in a drunken, drug-induced stupor. Marty was still shut up in the back of the van with the headless body of Kilburn Jerry. Those days, being black was even worse than being Irish. They threw the book at Marty.
So Marty did 10 years because Freddie Hurst fell asleep.
Wow.
Okay, maybe he did deserve it.
Yep.
No, because some kid was being ridden against his will by a bullying psychotic lunatic.
You f***.
Larry.
Crazy Larry was gay.
Took liberties with too many straight lads. Freddie's in intensive care with a bit of a brain hemorrhage. You were there. That's called joint venture. Now, Freddie dies. You're either in the dock with Marty or you're in the witness box putting him away.
This guy just can't get a break.
No, it's been a bad week.
Where's Joe?
I don't know.
What do you mean you don't know?
Well, go f***ing find him!
What the f*** am I going to do about this, sir?
I have something for you.
You're going to need one of these.
He said he doesn't like guns.
When I hate guns.
Although that one is really pretty, isn't it? Is that Second World War?
Hey!
Oh, look, he's auditioning for 007.
There we go, exactly.
It's a cool shot.
Yeah, they're using the bottles to kind of frame everything up. Really neat. Tap down establishing, there's the gun chilling. Right next to him.
My name is Dragon.
How do you get this number?
Boatman Paul gave me your number. Well, I believe you have some property that belongs to my employer. You're the person I should talk to about the return of this cargo stolen by your associate.
Not my associate.
The Duke has nothing to do with me. Why don't you come around for breakfast? I'll squeeze some orange juice and grind some coffee. We can talk about this like adults. How's that sound?
Sounds very hospitable.
Do you know where I live?
No.
Well, f*** off then.
Suddenly he likes guns.
Calm down.
I'm sure Duke's just fine.
Yeah, well, you've got 48 hours to find the buyer. I'm sending him back, okay? We've gone underground, mate. Off the radar. Nothing personal, but I don't trust you.
I just had a phone call from Gaza. Threatening to offload those pills in 48 hours. He's promised Jimmy a bumper payday, so you better get busy, hadn't you?
Well, I hope you put this dragon straight.
Yeah, I told him to fuck off.
Please tell me you're fucking joking.
We've got to find the Duke. Find these fucking pills.
Maybe this dragon geezer's already found the Duke.
Yeah, well, there is someone I can call.
What took you so long to call?
I've been busy.
So when am I going to see you? No, I was just lying in bed.
Wondering what to do.
Wonder no longer.
I know.
I was just rubbing the phone against my fanny. Did you like it?
Oh, please don't be dragon.
It's gonna be dragon.
Woo! Wow! So close. He was so close.
It's like so many of my dreams, right? When I'm about to bang the hot chick, I get hauled off.
Oh, this is gonna be... Well, no. Holy shit.
I'm Jimmy's old colleague. Eddie Temple, he told you to locate my daughter. Hunt her down like some lost mongrel.
He said you asked for his help.
Mr. Troop, find anyone on the planet in 10 minutes flat. If you laid a finger on my little daughter, Charlotte, you'd be over the edge like that. Join that other little shit, Kinky. You thought he could take my $5,000 and f*** me over. You're a smart boy, but you keep very, very bad company.
Who are you telling, bro?
You know, I have a charity golf tournament every year. Jimmy, as usual, on the lookout for tip, has made the acquaintance of the development minister of some tin pot republic. They're trawling the West for investments. They have vast deposits of natural resources. They've even made him an honorary citizen. Even made him one of the tribe. What we didn't know is bad news about our little venture, Jim. The communists have broken through the government lines, heading for the capital. It's all over, Jimmy.
Get my money out, quick, now.
As if it was some little kiddie's piggy bank. Now, I explained that wasn't possible. Have a drink, forget about it. You win some, you lose some.
How much are we talking here, Mr. Temple?
Yeah.
Only a cheeky half mil, Jim.
No, it isn't.
How much?
13.
Million?
How could you be so f***ing stupid?
Don't you talk to me like that.
You accuse me of instigating it. You demented.
So Jimmy thought he could keep Charlotte hostage while you went to Zurich to get his money back.
Little Jimmy was so stupid, he thought he couldn't lose either way. But if you find Charlotte, he's got his hostage. If I find you trying to find her, I do his dirty work.
I'm still not with you.
You see, I've found out something very interesting about Jimmy.
Could you not have given him an hour to f*** that girl?
Can we make a stop before we go see Jimmy?
Now you sit back, relax, enjoy.
It ain't like doing business for your lot in the old days.
Tell me about it, Jim.
Great transition. Love that.
Those wired up college boys from anti-corruption.
$10,000.
All right, so go and wait, Jim. Now what about Gene? Does he suspect anything?
About me working for the old firm. Listen, Gene
is too loyal for his own good.
Where did you get this?
Mr. Troop made it for me. It's one of his little hobbies. Don't you want to hear what Jimmy has to say about you?
Just give us a name and he's gone.
Flash, young run. One of the new breed, isn't he? Rexing just walks off into retirement.
Nice push in.
Well, if he's got a killer class A on board, he's looking at double figures.
I'll put it there myself.
It's me
set him up with that slippery account in the first place. Fucking ragged. Let slip, didn't he?
Ain't you? The flash runt who thinks he's retiring?
Can I have that?
Mr. Troop. This looks like you, son. Always remember, the art of good business is being a good middleman. Bye-bye.
Cheerio and all that.
Yeah, he is.
He's having a bad, bad week. I think I'd score more like.
I love it.
Pushing city.
Beautiful.
How deep are they going? Jeez.
Beautiful. That first AC earned every penny.
That might have been two shots. I thought I saw like a little mini fade in there.
Well, they definitely had it for this pullout, because that's brilliant. Can these guys know how to f-ing transition? This was an audition take for Bond. Oh, what a lovely garden. Perfect place to die. Ooh. Ooh, they kept the beep though. Oh, that was awesome.
Don't let it bother you.
Yep. Ooh. Never done something like that before. Oh.
Oh.
Yes. I've got him. Sydney.
Oh, Singh's left. He's gone. So now his money's gone.
Oh, shit. That's right.
Hello.
Shut up and listen. No more insults. No more games. If I do not get my cargo back, you're a dead man.
Dragon, I've been doing some checking. I think I can point you in the direction of your boss's merchandise.
Come to my hotel room now.
No, look, please. I don't mean to be discourteous, but I think I'd rather meet you in a public place.
I have nothing to fear.
Yeah, I do.
That's not what I've heard. I'll meet you at Greenwich Park Observatory tomorrow, midday.
Have a look at the geyser at the front. This could get a bit messy, you know.
You stay here. Those pills move. You call me, right?
Yeah, you go.
I didn't feel too summoned.
I want a library like that.
I know, right?
Oh, being a clever bastard, are we? You had pills. How much the lot?
Oh, I've already got a buyer.
Let me match his offer.
See, the thing is, if I sold them to you, I'd have to disappoint him.
I did you a big f***ing favor letting you know about Jimmy.
You gotta stop. Card out quick. Yeah, you gotta stop owing people.
So if I gave you $3 million, that'd keep everyone happy. Very, very unhappy if you don't sell him to me.
$3 million done.
What are you playing, son?
I'm gonna need some help. Someone who can eliminate the problem.
Tuesday, I'm paying over the odds, remember? England, typical. Even drug dealers don't work weekends.
No, they don't. Wow.
Hey, you know what's up? What's the good news, Dean?
Yeah? What's that?
You're murdered and bastard!
Dean, open the f***ing door! Who is that?
Jimmy!
Dead?
He killed him!
Oh! F***ing dog, you hear me? Why?
Ow! Oh!
What the f***? Get off here!
No, Nick!
I got a call earlier from a cousin we've got bent. They found Jimmy's body last night. The sly bastard!
Oh, wow.
Murder weapon used in unsolved homicide of Lawrence Francis Gower, also known as Crazy Larry Flint.
Gun was the same! The one he stole from my flat!
You killed Crazy Larry.
Yeah, but wait till you hear why.
He wasn't his father! He was a blatant father!
Jimmy, a grass!
I've got a recording at home. If he's lying, we'll both f***ing kill him.
Mr. Mortimer reckons the Tylers.
A deli shot again, love it.
It's nice.
What about Jimmy? About me working for the odd firm.
Convinced?
But Jimmy was skint, huh? That's why he set up the whole Amsterdam business with Duke.
Mm. Why did you kill Larry?
After that business with Kilmore and Jerry.
That's it, son. You do him. Bollocks!
He wanted him gone. So what's the next move, boss?
So when does the target get here, then?
The target's gonna be here at exactly midday.
You got a photo?
No, it's okay. Don't worry about it.
After we do the business, walk slowly back. Don't run, whatever you do. So try to stay relaxed.
Awkward.
There.
Time. 6 minutes to 12.
I hope this fella's not going to be late.
You don't even know what he looks like.
Can you see that guy on the left?
Big fella, marching up the hill.
That's our man.
Are you sure?
I'm gonna call him.
As soon as he answers, he's gone, okay?
Okie dokie.
Stand by. Now.
Hello.
Don't
move a muscle.
Don't you, you're dealing with a professional, bro.
Do I have your attention?
Yes.
You have no idea of honor and respect. I want my cargo and the Duke.
I haven't got your pills yet, Dave.
Ooh.
Don't piss in my pocket and tell me it's raining. You bring me what is mine.
No, I don't.
Jesus. See you tomorrow at dusk by the statue. And remember, I will be watching you.
Should've just met with him. Yep.
Oh. What the f*** were you taking about?
Exactly, baby.
Dragon's already killed Paul. He's done the Duke. He just put a bullet right between Lucky's eyes. I was f***ing there. He's watching our every move. I mean, who's next? Me?
I wish.
Oh, f*** off. Look, it could be you or Morty.
Dragon said he wanted the pills and the Duke. Where the f*** the Duke?
I should have told you this earlier.
I mean, I've got to get on my toes sharp as here, mate.
Oi! Archie meat brought here right now, yeah? Getting that smug f***ing yuppie Varta to tell Duke that those pills are useless. I'll call the f***ing law.
Wait, wait, Sasha, what are you talking
about? Whoa, shut up.
No, she didn't mean that.
I
didn't she didn't mean that. She was upset.
I f***ing do call the f***ing law, Will.
Didn't mean
I'll call the f***ing law.
Oh.
That's where playing the being a gangster gets you.
Now, Duke, for once you might be of some use.
That was Gaz on the phone. It's on.
Best of luck.
How many people does he owe these pills to now?
Gaz, this place stinks. We want to get you out of here. 50 pence a pill. At least that way, we all come out with something in our pockets.
Yeah, I think they're worth a lot more than that.
Paul's dead. Jimmy's dead. Duke and Slasher f*** knows where they are.
This gear is knockoff, and the Serbs you nicked it from, well, they kill you like you'd take a piss.
Oh, I love this. So intense.
Yeah, it's good action.
Yeah. Oh, there are your pills. I think it was a snorri cam. Hey, Sydney. Dumbass.
Hi.
Well, they do have your truck, though.
And your drugs.
And you're painting your drugs.
Is this for me?
Ooh.
Damn, that guy's slick.
Yep.
Your cargo's gone, I'm afraid. Seized by...
I know already.
How do you know?
I watched.
Right, leave it to me, lads. I'll explain to Inspector Cox that it's suspect.
This guy knows.
Scarpa, because you're blundering.
Does this settle things, then?
Would have been nice to have an answer.
Where is my f***ing prisoner? You old ladies couldn't catch a f***ing cold if you tried! Shut up, you soppy wanker!
So where are the pills, genius? What the f***?
Slick.
You are in the wrong game, mate. You should work with us. So your pills are in the back. Help yourself.
Do you have the pills?
In the cars.
Boss wants to see you in his office.
Can't we just do this out here?
Sit down. Yeah, payment. You look shocked, son.
You taking a f***ing piss?
I've caused my little angel Charlotte considerable anxiety. I'm keeping those pills for myself by way of compensation. I think I'm entitled. The amount of trouble you've caused the last few days, I think it would be in your interest if this thing finishes here now, today. Understand?
This lot are going to come after you.
No, they're too long in the tooth to go
rampaging around the country looking for revenge.
Are you enjoying this?
No, on the contrary, take it as a compliment. This monkey business is in your blood, under your skin. You're not getting out, you're just getting in. You're only getting started. And one day in the future, it'll be you sitting here in my place, telling some young Turk the facts of life.
And they are, Mr. Temple.
You're born, you take shit, get out in the world, you take more shit, climb a little higher, take less shit, till one day you're up in the rarefied atmosphere and you've forgotten what shit even looks like. Welcome to the layer cake, son.
Welcome to the layer cake.
This thing ends here tonight, you understand? Drug money's easy money, not grief. The odds, as you can see, are against you. Good night.
Well, that sucks.
Yep.
If you're going to hang around in this game, that's where you've got to aim to be. Sitting in your bonded warehouse with the ex-professional soldiers doing the dirty work while you deliver the highly suspect educational lecture to baffle your opponents and cover your tracks. It's all about honor and respect.
This is the end, Mr. Duke. As I told you. Pilule?
Polizia.
Always more.
And enjoy that, brother.
It's like the old days, Shanks.
Where do you want the money sent, lad?
And again, look, I am sorry about Lucky.
Worry about it, killer. Mum was a prick anyway.
Did I really think Eddie was going to give me 3 million for those pills? But suddenly, there was a void where once there was Jimmy Price. Eddie's little getting in and getting out speech started to make sense.
Brilliant.
Then they're having layer cake.
Long live the king.
But for me, this is all over. Getting out.
What was true then is true now.
Have a plan, stick to it.
So I'm sure you gentlemen must have lots to discuss, but I have no business being here.
Slick.
Kilburn Jerry, Crazy Larry, Mr. Lucky, Jimmy. I don't want to add my name to that list. My name? If you knew that, you'd be as clever as me.
Whoa!
I'm sorry.
Killed by an idiot.
He was out! Also, not a very expensive song. Wow.
I do not remember that film at all.
Do you think he'd seen this movie, or do you think he'd just seen that scene enough that you were like...
Maybe that, because I honestly didn't really know where it was going.
Yeah, that's good.
I was like, I didn't remember any of the story, so maybe I didn't see it. Maybe I just thought I saw it.
There you go.
Like, the only thing I remember is the layer cake speech. That's it. That was good. It's a good movie.
That was very good.
Yeah, it was fun.
So many moving parts.
Kind of a nice medium between, like, you know, a gentleman or rock and roller, which, like, there's so many storylines going on. This one has a lot, but I feel like it's a little more streamlined. I mean, I followed Rock and Roller, but I felt like it was just a little complicated. This one was like, this is like very well done.
Yeah. I could actually see literally this being one of those films where, like, someone saw him and was like, oh yeah, he's the next Bond.
Like, he does have that swag. I mean, maybe
the walk alone and everything. Like, that's that walk he does.
Think it's though because we know he is Bond and we've seen him as Bond in the last like two or three movies or whatever it is, that now we just sort of like only think of him as Bond?
Yes, definitely. But it's interesting to see,
like,
because
he
definitely had to bring some of these characters or just his natural swag to Bond, which obviously made his Bonds very specific and iconic, but you could see it here.
Yeah.
When he
held the gun up, I was like, it almost looks like the classic James Bond pose, you know, he always does in a movie. Totally. You know, for somebody who's a criminal, he like does it in a way that he's very likable too.
Oh yeah. Yeah. I mean his whole plan was to do just enough quote unquote damage, make his money and go.
Unfortunately, there's other people who have other plans.
Yes.
Including shooting you at the end of the movie because you're dating his hot girlfriend.
Yep.
Some movie recently. Was it in a movie we watched where it's like that's the problem with beautiful girls is like there's always some other guy who thinks she's beautiful too? And
oh yeah. What did we watch? I don't think we watched something like that, but I...
Is that something we watched together? Well, I think we should have a layer cake as our thing this week. And how many out of 5 do you give this one?
This one gets a 9 out of 10 for me. I really liked this.
9 out of 5, you mean?
Yeah, 9 out of 5. The camera work's brilliant. I loved how they use the transitions. Okay. Yeah, exactly.
That one crazy dolly into his face that then we dolly out and it's like
him
in the mask.
Yeah.
And I like, no, I think it was like, I think it's really a good film. I'll give it a 9 as well.
There you go.
But in my mind I'm really thinking 10, but I'm gonna give it a 9 just in case. That's good for me.
Yeah.
I really liked it.
I did too.
It's a good recommendation, folks.
Yeah, thank you so much. The recommendation. We'll obviously see you back on the couch for the next movie next week.
Maybe.
But for right now, maybe not him.
Maybe not me.
He always threatens that. That's his thing.
Always. Threats are always my thing.
But hey, we'll see you in the comments per usual. Let us know if there's any BTS or information we should know about the script or the writer or the actors or any of that stuff.
BTS? Like the band?
BTS. Like, no. Like, behind the scenes information.
What does BTS stand for, by the way? Not behind the scenes, but the band.
I don't know.
You know? I don't know.
No.
Does anybody know that?
Let us know in the comments with BTS, the Korean band, right? It's the Korean band?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Blind Turkey Service or something like that?
Blind Turkey Service? Boys That Sing.
Hey. Do the socials,
yeah.
Do the likes and the subscribes and all those things. We got another Patreon the other day, which was very nice. And we'll be back here next week. Keep commenting because we are reacting to the comments that come in. Anyway, right. We'll see you guys next week.
See you next week. We're out.
Or I should do this. This is what the Brits do.
What is this?
It means golf.
Oh, you geezer. No.